racist, so have fun. So despite the fact that she called this person a cave dweller, despite the fact that she had a past of tweeting about white people and that she called this person pasty, she's saying, well, I didn't say it to all white people. I didn't say it to every white person in America. So it's totally fine as long as I'm only being racist towards one white person. And of course, this was not enough for people that discovered who she was. By the way, her real name is Danielle Allen. They began to insist that something be done, but she was still confident nothing would be done. In fact, she posted this video of herself walking down the hallways at that elementary school, and she wrote this: first day of school, walking through the halls while Twitter thinks they can take my job from me. Ha ha, little smiley face. Call me every name under the sun, but y'all will never be able to call me unemployed. Wow. That's how it started. Here's how it's going, folks. Turns out we actually can call her unemployed because the school district got wind of this and they posted this all across their socials. This is again in Mesquite, Texas. They posted this all across their socials and as well as on the actual school website for the district. They wrote this: at approximately 4 p.m. yesterday, Mesquite ISD, Independent School District, became aware of a series of alarming racist statements posted to the X, formerly Twitter, account of a teacher at Thompson Elementary. Upon learning of the situation, our personnel staff began an immediate investigation. As of this morning, the employee is no longer a part of the Mesquite Independent School District organization and is not eligible for rehire. Due to privacy restrictions, Mesquite cannot comment on the details of personnel matters. Nevertheless, the highly offensive statements posted to our X account do not reflect the values and standards of Mesquite, and the district condemns them in the strongest terms. So yeah, she is unemployed. And it just really, take a second, actually step back and think about this. She got triggered by a white arm and lost her entire job. It wasn't even like, it wasn't even like a sexy pose. Like, it was just a white guy's arm that was around her sister. And she got so triggered that she went on a racist rant, texted her boyfriend, was willing to lose her job. She's now lost her job. She couldn't stop herself, right? She could have instantly realized, she could have started deleting things. Then she involved the school district by saying, they said my job's fine, which obviously only enraged people further. And all of this because she couldn't bear looking at a white arm. That's the truth. This is what actually happened. And I have more questions. I want to know personally what her sister is thinking. Can you imagine? You probably are finding out everything that's happening secondhand and going, are you good? Did you just actually lose it all over a white arm? Because it sounds like her sister, and obviously, given the fact that her sister was with a white man, she does not hold the same racist perspectives as her sister does. And she's probably thinking, what did you just do? Because her life is blown up. Make no mistake. She's not hireable. Everybody knows who Danielle Allen is now in the state of Texas. When she goes to apply for a job and people look her up, they're going to see her face associated with the story, no matter where you work. Whether you're talking about McDonald's or any other corporation, she is now unable to be hired as a teacher anywhere. She's done being a teacher. Maybe McDonald's will hire her. Maybe Burger King will hire her. And people will walk in. They'll get their Big Macs. They'll get their Whoppers. And they'll think, pretty sure that's the girl that said she was a black supremacist, right? That is actually, her life is blown up. That's all that is left for her because she couldn't help but be racist. She got exactly what she deserved. But I got to get involved in this family drama. So if you are her sister and you are watching this, we will pay you $500 to give us the exclusive to sit down with us and talk to us about what your sister just did, blowing up her own life. And if you are the white arm, just the white arm, we will give you $400 to sit down with us and give us the exclusive interview about what happened, what it felt like as the white arm in that scenario, and to realize that your white arm is now basically famous on the internet. So, ladies and gentlemen, the lesson to be learned is that America is beginning to stand up to racism in all of its forms, not just racism that is being directed in one direction.
Okay. I wanted to make a little quick stitch to this video. I've seen a lot of people discussing this woman. I think her name is Danielle Allen or whatever like that. She's a teacher from Texas that was recently fired because she went on pretty much a racist rant all over social media, on Twitter or whatnot. A lot of you black women are going to learn. There's some jobs that you cannot do that type of stuff and think you're going to still be employed. But she got mad because her sister was on a date, or a white man was with her sister, or her sister's dating white men. And so she went on a rant pretty much saying that Her sister is smashing a cave dweller. And then she also doubled down when people discovered her true identity, her real name, and where she worked at. She doubled down and said that she's not going to be unemployed and she's not going to lose her job and all of that. Well, now she's fired. She's fired. Because she didn't know when to shut her fucking mouth and what not to come on social media and say. I don't know why whoever her sister is dating or on a date with will bother her that bad. But there are black women that want nothing but a black male that sucks and screw black males, that like to police black women's bodies and that like to police what black women do in relationships with white and non-black men, telling them what they should tolerate, what they should get out of these men, what type of money they need to get, and why you with that white guy. And I never understand why black women that fucking suck nothing but black males are always in black women's business that deal with white men. Regardless if it's a transactional relationship, regardless if she's a sugar baby, a girlfriend, a wife to this white man, you will always find these women that take nothing but the black male's sick penis. Okay? That has dealt with him, that are married to him, that sleep with him only. Always trying to tell women that don't date black men what to do. That's none of your fucking business. And for black women that deal with white men in whatever type of relationship you deal with them, if it's transactional relationship, sugar baby, wife, fiance, friendship, lover, whatever way you deal with this non-black man, this white man, these black women that deal with black men need to stay out of your fucking business. It doesn't matter if they're a family member or if they are your best friend, or, you know, women from social media or women from work. They have no business telling you what to do. They don't. But I've noticed that they are so nosy, and you can tell they're so unhappy with these black males that they stay in your business. Like, why are you even around black women that don't deal with Negroes in the first place? Why do you care what they do with white men? Why do you care if they sleep with them or whatever they do with them? That's none of your fucking business. You're sleeping with the group of men that are on the bottom of the barrel. You're sleeping with the men that unalive black women the most. How dare you tell somebody what to do with the white man and how to regulate their body and what they shouldn't do with their life? You should be the last person telling somebody what to do. You're literally sleeping with the enemy. You're literally sleeping with black men don't give a fuck about you. You're literally sleeping with the same group of men that unalive black women 4 or 5 times daily. Daily. No one can trust your judgment, and nobody should listen to any advice you have to give. I see that on YouTube and social media a lot, on TikTok also, Twitter also. These black women that are all about the black male, want nothing but black male children, always in the business of black women that don't deal with black men, always trying to tell them what to do with their cootie cat, with their body, how they need to act, and what they need to do with these non-black men, and what they need to tolerate from them, and how they need to get them, and all this. That's none of your business. You're not getting anything from the nigga but come and used up peen. That's all y'all getting. Passed down peen that all of y'all are recycling and using over and over again. Why is it any of your business? Mind your business what black women do with non-black men. And so, because she wanted to mind her sister's business and tell her sister what to do, and she was so pressed about this white man, they also discovered, like, text messages of her talking to her black boyfriend about coming over and unaliving the white man, because I think the white man was over to her house with her sister or whatever like that, and she was trying to get her boyfriend to unalive the white man and talking about she would help hide the body. Black women like this make me sick. This is who non-black people and majority of the public think that we are. These black women that suck and screw black males. The ones that are married to them and birth their children constantly out of wedlock. This is who they think majority of us are like. They judge us all the same. They judge us for the mistakes and the things that these women right here do. All black women don't fit in the same box. All of us don't hate non-black people. We're not racist like you. All of us don't want black males. We don't want to be married to them. We don't want children by them. So stop trying to control everything that other black women do. That's a problem that I have with black women. They're always trying to tell you what to do with your life. They're always trying to police you, your body, your cootie cat, and always in your fucking business. I'm not taking any advice from black women that sleep with black men that are married to the bottom of the barrel group of men on the planet. Why the fuck would I listen to anything you're saying? You're insane. You have to be insane to be attracted to black males. You have to be crazy to want to marry and to sleep with them. You have to be. So there's no way in hell I would sit around and listen to anything you would have to say. I wouldn't care. So for black women that deal with non-black men, white men, I don't care what type of relationship it is, transactional, sugar baby, girlfriend, wife, fiance, lover, friend, whatever it is, stop allowing these bitches who fuck black males and who are married to black males tell you what the fuck to do. These women need to be worrying about whether they're catching STDs and HIV. They need to be worried about their own cootie cats when they deal with the black male, not yours. Not yours. So, rightfully so, she lost her job. And then she was bold enough to come online and say, oh, I'm not going to get fired. I'm not going to lose my job. You cannot be racist towards white people and think that you're going to be a teacher. That's not going to happen. You're never going to be a teacher again. Ever. They're going to know your name. They're going to know your face. And you will never work with children. Most likely you ain't going to work with the elderly. You ain't going to work with the public like that because you're racist. And anytime these non-black people find out who you are, they're going to call your job or whatever like that and get you fired. Plain and simple. Just like these black people go around trying to get these white people fired, mess up their business, get them to lose their jobs, get them locked up. They're going to do the same thing with you. Same thing. So, you know, black women is always on the front lines. I see this happening a lot. I even see this happening with black women that date white men. They will get online with these racist rants and get on TikTok and say all kind of crazy things about white people and say, oh, no, I'm talking about these type of white people. I'm not talking about these type of white people. Even though you're laying down with a white man, make it make sense. You are some of the most confused, dimback, bird brain ass women I've ever come across. You black women that sleep with white men and continue to try to be pro-black and continue to be racist towards white people, even if you're racist towards white women, because black people can be racist. I don't know why people think that they can't. There's a lot of racist black people in this world, just like there's racist white people, just like there are racist Hispanic people, just like there are racist Asian people. Everybody's capable of being racist. So don't say black people can't be racist, but black women, stop being on the front line trying to be the most racist pro-black group of women you can be. You're not winning any rewards. You're not getting any kind of brownie points. The black male's not coming to you. The black male prefers to be with non-black women. That's who he prefers to be with, not you. A lot of times he deals with you because you're his second choice. He knows that you're his bottom bitch and you'll do anything to be with him. You'll do anything to be gloating about being married to a black male. You're literally married to failure. Make it make sense. If you're out here trying to advocate and tell women what to do with their bodies, telling women how they need to live and what they need to not do and all about how you morally better than other women. No, there's nothing morally better by a bitch that's slurping on a black male. Nothing. You're a laughing stock. The joke is on you. You literally am dealing with the bottom of the barrel group of men. You win no points. So stop taking advice from these women. These women are in no position to tell you what to do with your life, especially if they're married to black males, if they're dating them and they want to be with them. They are in no position to ever give you an advice about life. Give you advice about what you need to be doing with white and non-black men. They need to mind their business, but a lot of these women are miserable with black males, so they stay in the business of women who deal with white men because they have no business. They have no life. The black male doesn't want them. A lot of times they're taking care of the black male. He's not doing anything for them but pumping and dumping them and using them up. That's pretty much what it is. So Another thing, if you're gonna date non-black men, don't subject them to black people's racism. If you know your family members don't like white people, don't bring him around them. He shouldn't have to put up with that. He shouldn't have to get in no argument or possibly get in a fight or get assaulted by your family members or your friends because you want to bring them around. If you know these people don't like white people, they don't like non-black people, exclude them out your life. But don't subject somebody else to put up with their crap. If you know your sister's racist, your brother, your mother, your father's racist, don't bring your person around them. Avoid them at all costs. Because you're grown. They can't tell you what to do. Either they're going to get with it or they don't. But don't include them in every aspect of your life if they don't like that you're dating a non-black person. Have some respect for your partner or whoever you're dealing with that is non-black and exclude them out of your life. And that's all I have to say about that whole thing. She's going to learn her lesson. She is learning her lesson that coming on social media, especially revealing your face, saying some of these crazy things will get your job took. Okay? And everybody's capable of being racist. It doesn't matter the race. And that's all I got to say about that. Like, share, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.